first draft. It's been a while. You should welcome me back.
I better see you in the comments welcoming me back.
Now you may be asking, why is he wearing a hat? Well, frankly, it's Canada and it's cold. But also, I'm a boomer and I'm losing my hair. But we're back for Draft League! Yes, that's right. I'll be uploading this league. Will I be uploading every week? Who knows? You're gonna have to subscribe to find out. So do that. We're gonna be doing a little bit of a team builder today, and I'm gonna be showing you the week one match for the UPA. If you guys don't remember, the UPA was the first league I joined, and I'm back with a vengeance. Now, a lot of people questioned my first round pick. I was picking, I think, fifth. I picked up Dragapult. If you want to see my full team, here it is. And my opponent's team over on the right. Now, during the draft, my opponent said I had no real fighting resist. And while that may be true, he has no real ghost resist. So Dragapult, first round, let's put in some work. Now let's go over the team that we're bringing for Mr. Turk. First mon, Dragapult. Choice specs, max special attack, modest, with only 80 speed. If you noticed, my man only has a mega arrow and his next fastest mon is a Mean Shao. So I'm outspeeding that and only that. I'm very well aware that it can come scarf. It's likely to come scarfed against me. I don't care. I'm gonna get outsped by Mega Arrow regardless. 176 HP. This might be important. It might also not be important. You're gonna have to find out when we get to the game portion of the video. The moves, Hex, Shadow Ball, Fire Blast, and U-Turn. Magearna gets hit harder by Fire Blast if it's not statused. However, the likelihood of any of his mons not being statused during the game is extremely low, and I'll show you why. Let's move on to the next map. First status mon, Seismitoad. We got Toxic, Stealth Rock, Earthquake, and Scald. Max HP, max defense with an impish nature. Turk has a Zekrom. If I don't bring this, I'm dead. Stealth Rocker on there to help out with General Chip. Toxic would be nice for the Mantine, which is likely to come against me, as my Uber is a Groudon. And leftovers. We were Swift Swim during the game. I forgot to change this to Water Absorb. That did not come into play. When I imported the team into Showdown, I forgot to change it. Big whoop. Move on to the next. Our Silver Uber, Mega Blaziken. Now this thing is designed to put momentum pressure on his team with U-Turn. Slowbro's a likely switch-in. Mantine can come in, but there's a threat of Thunder Punch, which you can see that I'm running. We got U-Turn, we got Will-O-Wisp, because again, we want to status everything. And finally, the last move is Flare Blitz, because of course, Sun Boosted Flare Blitz from a Pokemon with 160 base attack is going to hurt just about everything not named Slowbro or Mantine. The speed on there is for Crook. If Crook comes, it's less likely to be Scarf than Mean Shao, I feel, just because I have infinite pivoting options against Crocodile. Basically, everything on my team is outspeeding Crook and only Crook other than Dragapult, which is outspeeding Mean Shao. Thundurus, a good old friend, back to the Montreal Habsols. We're running Thunderbolt, Defog, U-Turn, and yes, another status move, Thunder Wave. I don't have a lot of defoggers. I do need to make sure that rocks stay off the field because Blaziken has to come in pretty often. Same thing with Dragapult, so I'm gonna be trying to avoid that as much as possible. That's why we're running Defog. U-Turn's on there for the Crocodile because I don't wanna run Grass Knot. There's no point against his team, and just getting momentum on that thing is way better than anything else. And obviously, Thunderbolt can put in some work in the late game if everything's weakened. If, say, he only has Mantine, Slowbro, and Magearna left, can do a lot of work. The item, Heavy Duty Boots. I don't want to take rocks damage, especially if I'm trying to get rid of rocks. That'd be counterproductive. Next mon, Groudon, our Gold Uber. Now, I'm bringing a special set here this week because I feel that it does a little bit more work to his team. Yes, base 150 is obviously a lot higher than base 100, but the addition of Solar Beam and Fire Blast on the set, I feel, makes it worth it. And of course, you guys see the last move on there. It's another status move, another Thunder Wave. His team's very weak to Thunder Wave. He only has one ground type in Crocodile, so Thunder Wave is extremely spammable, and it could be a huge deterrent to Pokemon like Victini and Mean Shao, and especially Mega Aerodactyl. The item, leftovers, easy. I wish Groudon had another ability because this is one instance where I actually don't want to run Sun, but I need to bring Groudon because I need both of my ground types for specific checking. Regardless, we move. Last mon, Celesteela. I need a Magearna check. This is pretty much all I got. We're running Fire Blast, Shockwave, Toxic. Yes, the last status move on the team. And last move, Leech Seed, because I feel like that's gonna help the team recover a little bit. My team is very short on natural, reliable recovery, so Celesteela is a huge help to that. With that said, let's get into the battle. And here we are. As you can see, Turk Brot, Slowbro, Magearna, Mansine, Zekrom, Victini, and Mean Shao. Basically, the main Mons that I mentioned during the team builder. Why did I do that? Because that's all I could remember he had. So I apologize for my horrible memory. Anyway, let's start the match and see what happens. I decide to lead with Thundurus because I feel like it has a pretty good matchup against his entire team, save maybe Victini. Mean Shao doesn't knock it out in one. Zekrom can try to set up on me. It's also not gonna knock me out in one. Everything else doesn't really appreciate Volt Switch or U-Turn. I don't have Volt Switch, but he doesn't know that yet. Turk decides to lead off with Mean Shao, and at this point, I'm gonna stop looking you guys dead in the eyes, and I'm gonna look at the screen because I gotta remember what happened. So I U-Turn out on Mean Shao, bring out Blaziken. I decide to throw out a Will-O-Wisp. Looks pretty free against his team. Doesn't have anything that stops it. I get off a Will-O-Wisp on the Slowbro. Now it's a Hex target for Dragapult. We're gonna U-turn out. We're gonna go right out into Dragapult. Turk makes a nice play and weakens me with Ice Beam, puts me down to 50%. Now this is gonna be pretty crucial. Keep in mind that my Dragapult is at 50% from turn two or turn three. I believe that was turn three. I decide to U-turn out on the Magearna and we are going to bring in the big threat, Groudon. And we're just gonna throw out a Thunder Wave. My opponent decides to go into Slowbro, immune to Thunder Wave thanks to the burn. Very nice play. Could have Earth Powered there and Solar Beam subsequently would have killed. But instead I take a Grass Knot, take a huge amount of damage, 60%. Grass Knot's a good bring. I have a Seismitoad, I have a Groudon. I pretty much expected it, but I decided to get off the damage on Slowbro. I felt like it would be better for Blaziken in the long run. I decided to go for a Thunder Wave on the following turn, catching the Mantine, knowing that he'd probably switch out. Then I go into Celesteela on a Toxic, because it was pretty much the only play with Sunup, and I decide to Shockwave, and he does predict it correctly and goes into Zekrom. I decide for some reason to go for a Toxic here with Celesteela. Now this is a horrible play. I probably should have just hard switched into Seismitoad and gone for an Earthquake, but the Toxic damage is gonna be nice racking up on the Zekrom. It's gonna be pretty much guaranteed to die at some point. We just don't know when yet. So here I'm gonna go out into Seismitoad, obviously. My opponent, Turk, decides to Dragon Dance again. Now, Outrage is a roll, but it does not KO me. I go for Earthquake. He brought Shuka, pretty much expected. But the Zekrom is down to 33%, and I'm gonna get out of there and go into Celesteela on the Outrage, and Zekrom gets confused on the second turn of Outrage, takes some more poison damage, and I go into Thundurus, and Confusion kills it off. So we will never know, unless we ask Turk himself, whether or not the Zekrom clicked Outrage or Fusion Bolt. Most likely clicked Outrage again, so that means that I have an extra sack here, thanks to that Confusion hit. I'm gonna switch out into Celesteela on the Magearna, and Flare Cannon comes out. That's pretty much what I predicted. Didn't see an electric move coming, considering Thundurus was in. I go for Toxic here on the Magearna, Volt switches out, very good play. Goes into Victini. Now this thing's a threat, I don't know what to do. I decide to go into Thundurus, and the Victini goes for Zen Headbutt. I live on 7%, and I decide to go for a Thunder Wave, and now the Magearna is also paralyzed. So pretty much everything is statused here, except for the Victini and the Mean Shao. Grass Knot comes out from the Magearna, knocks out my Thundurus. I go into Seismitoad, and I decide to throw out Stealth Rocks. Mantine comes in, and I realize at this point, okay, my rocks just aren't staying up. So I decide to switch out into Celesteela on the Defog, and knowing that the Mantine is unlikely to want to stay in, I'm going to double into Dragapult here on Slowbro. So this is going to be a pretty much a free hex here. Knock out Slowbro and we're up 5-4. Mean Shao comes in, screams Choice Scarf. I go into Blaziken, catches me with the U-turn. Very good play. Victini comes in, and I was a little perplexed that Victini came in, but I decide to just U-turn on it, get a crit. Trick Room goes up. Celesteela heals a little bit. And yeah, by the way, this thing is Trick Room. So it's a problem. V-Create comes out on my Blaziken. I know that I can take two of those if he's not adamant. So this pretty much proves that he's not adamant, but it also proves that he's max attack. So I have some information on this Victini. I'm going to switch around a little bit here on the Victini, go into Celesteela on the Zen Headbutt, knowing that the V-Create probably wouldn't kill from that range. Go for Leech Seed on the following turn, and V-Create comes out and knocks me out. Now we're tied 4-4. However, I have to sack another Mon to this Victini, thanks to the Trick Room still having one turn left on it. Now the Trick Room finally goes down, and I get in my Dragapult for free. Magearna comes out, and I decide to Hex, and go for another Hex, and it does not knock out Mean Shao, but 83% is very good. We find out in a few following turns that the Mean Shao is actually Regenerator, so good bring with the Choice Scarf, obviously. Now at this point, instead of knocking off, Turk goes for U-turn again as I bring in Groudon. I knew the Groudon could take two knockoffs, and Victini comes in, and actually outspeeds me. Now, here's the funny thing. If you guys were paying attention to the team builder, my Groudon has 299 speed. So either this was a complete speed tie, or this thing is jolly max speed with Trick Room. I even said in the chat right after the V-Create came off that I was surprised that Turk was max speed Trick Room. It didn't make much sense to me at the time, but now looking back at the matchup, kind of does. So Groudon goes down, and I'm going to bring in Mega Blaziken, and I'm going to go for a Flare Blitz to knock out the Magearna. I knew that I could get off the most damage possible on the Victini with Flare Blitz that turn. Speed Boost comes out, Mean Shao comes in, and he knows that he can outspeed me, and I'm going to explain this play here. So if I go into Dragapult, lose-lose, right? Unless he clicks High Jump Kick, but this thing can just close combat. So here I'm going to Thunder Punch. And the reason that I did that is because Turk has not seen Thunder Punch. Thus, he can go into Mantine, and even if it dies, he can still go back into Mean Shao after, or go into Victini, which at that point, if I'm Thunder Punch, he knows that I knock him out with absolutely nothing, and he can get up a Trick Room. So we end up clicking Thunder Punch on the switch out to Mantine, and it takes 89%. Now, right here, I can go for another Thunder Punch, and at this point, I'm thinking my only win con against the Trick Room Victini is for one, Sun to go down, and two, for me to paralyze it with Thunder Punch as it goes for Trick Room. I'm thinking that's the only way that I can win. However, I didn't think ahead. Victini comes out, and it goes for Trick Room as I Thunder Punch it. I get off 25%. I do not get the paralysis. Zen Headbutt comes out and knocks out my Blaziken. But if you guys remember from the team builder, Dragapult has 176 HP EVs. That's right. It lives V-Create. And I don't know if you noticed, but Trick Room's up. And I'm actually slower than Mean Shao. So I'm faster than it in Trick Room. So now all I have to do is click Shadow Ball twice, and I win the game. Now, I calc'd this during the game, and V-Create was a roll to kill me, and he needed an absolute max roll from max speed Jolly, which I also figured out during the game based on the V-Create damage on Blaziken that he was absolutely max speed Jolly and not Adamant. So he didn't speed time my Groudon, he was just faster than my Groudon. And V-Create does a max of 50% to my Dragapult set. So with Trick Room up, Turk actually gave me a win con in the end game that I didn't have. If he would have just knocked out Blaziken, I would have lost. But because he put up the Trick Room, I won the game. Now, not a lot of people can say they got swept by Dragapult in Trick Room. Turk has that luxury now. So we take a win week one. I'm not gonna update you guys on standings. I'm not gonna link my opponents in the description either because I don't think that any of them are uploading. I mean, I guess I'll do it if they ask me to and they decide to upload for the league now that they've seen my game. But either way, you guys are pretty much only gonna get a one-sided look at this league. But if you do enjoy following me and my draft league action that you haven't seen in probably 2 years now, then make sure to hit that subscribe button again. I know that a lot of you unsubscribed after I went inactive for a while. So get back on the train. I'm gonna try to upload every single week, win or loss. I don't really care at this point. It doesn't really matter. I hope you guys enjoyed the game regardless, and I will catch you guys on the next one.